Texas. So the first thing you guys need to do is make sure your car is jacked up properly. And number one, if you guys have never jacked up an all-track, this is a first for us. So looks like we just jacked up on the typical lift points, put a jack underneath on all four corners. Take off all four wheels. We're only going to do the left side and the side with the gas tank because those require actually a special fandangling, so we'll figure that out in just a minute. But this is pretty sweet. Freaking all-wheel drive Golf wagon. So we're going to do pretty much the unboxing of our S1 coilovers from SoloWorks. Major thanks to Glenn and Matt. Thanks, guys. You guys are freaking awesome. So let's unbox these bad boys. SoloWorks uses the MK7 SoloWork kit for the all-track. So
MK7R kit.
Yeah, the MK7, yeah, Golf R kit.
With 200 pound heavier spring.
There you go. So you guys can check these out. Pretty cool. Make sure everything's out of the box. Scratch them on the floor, please. Since they're brand new, we gotta bless them. Warning, please read before attempting any installation of the product. Do not use an impact gun to torque the shock shaft top nut down. You hear that? No torque gun on the main nut, which is this guy right here. Alright? That means you gotta use your Allen socket.
And I don't think they can see that.
Take it again. Yeah, that should be fine. Yeah, it's pointing straight down. So yeah, you gotta use your Allen socket and a wrench or a socket and hand tighten these down. Mainly probably because they don't want you guys scoring or messing up the shaft that's down here and causing premature failure. So make sure you guys read that warning label because that's super important. That's true, they do match your car's calipers.
They only come in blue.
You can't see them, so it doesn't even matter. Alright, so we're going to start on the rear today. And on the rear, you're going to need to use your T20 Torx and take out the three Torx screws, and I'll show you where. One here, one here, one here. What this is going to do is allow you to pull the fender liner back, and it's going to show you right up there this little tank. See if you guys can see that. There you go. You see that tank right there? All it has is a 13mm nut right there. See where my finger's at? You're going to take that off and you're going to pull straight down on it. Not hard, but pull straight down and move it out of the way, because that's going to let you get the nut that's right up there. Trying to get some more light. There you go. There's a nut for the shock that's up here. That shock has two of them, and they're both, I believe, 16 millimeters. Just double check that. Yep, 16 for the top. So take the three bolts off here, pull that back, 13 millimeter there. Pull the tank down and over to the left slowly. It's kind of hung on there, so I'll show you guys how to take that off in just a minute. Next, while you're doing that, you're going to need to break loose this one, this one, and this one. 18, 18, 13. These bolts need to be taken off. The ones against the back, they both, nope, actually just this one. You're going to need to hold it with the wrench. Same with this one, you got to hold it with the wrench so it doesn't just spin in a circle. So you're going to break this one loose first. This car is brand spanking new, so it's going to be a little difficult to remove. Make sure to turn your volume down. It's gonna get loud every now and then. The other guys are working on the other side while I work on this side and show you guys how to do this. So, these you can take off since they're actually held together by tension right now because they're under pressure. These are all nice and snug. Yeah. Remember which ones you take off, bolt-wise and nut-wise, because you gotta put them back the same way you took them off, the same way you put them back on, okay? So that's number one, and then the next one is the 13 millimeter over here, and you're gonna need a 13 wrench to hold that one in place. Okay, so now that you have all three bolts taken off, you're gonna wanna need to compress them with a jack, just a little bit, I say about an inch compressed. This will pretty much prep you for dropping the spring because you don't want this. This is under a lot of tension. So when you jack this, decompress the jack, it'll go down and the spring will come down slowly versus like shoot out at you. So make sure you guys do that. The next step is literally just taking the bolts off now. Since they're not under a lot of pressure, you can literally just unthread them. Since they're kind of threaded in there still with the other stuff being held to it, it will eventually come out. It's just going to take a little while. If you guys want to, you guys can use an impact gun right here. I never recommend using an impact gun for like just removing anything, especially in suspension components, because you can damage them. So just be careful and take your time. So that one's removed, and remember, keep the nut and bolt together,
and remember where you put, where this one came out of and the direction it came out of. Very, very straightforward though. So that's the first one. Now we got this one over here. I thought I could probably wiggle it out, but no. There you go, that one's out. So now that one is what holds the spring in. Actually the shock in, I'm sorry. The last one is gonna be the sway bar one. And this one's just loose enough that I can take it out by hand. Now on some cars they have an electronic level. Make sure you look for that because you can snap it off if you don't.
On the driver's side.
Yeah, so on this car it's on the driver's side like Max said. There's usually a little level around here by my hand on the driver's side. That controls a lot of the lighting in the car or ride height depending on like some cars. I don't know. Depending on what it does. Alright guys, so now that we have all three bolts removed, you'll see like the spindle in the rear brake is on the control arm. Or actually no, this is, I think it's a beam. I forgot what these are called, but now this is removed, completely independent from that. So now you're gonna drop your jack and make sure you drop it slowly because you don't wanna like hurt yourself with the spring. And just hold it. And that should, there you go, come right out. And then just yank this sucker out. Okay, that's the stock spring. Holy sweet baby Jesus, that thing's huge. I'm gonna go grab the rear, the Solo Works ones for a comparison. This is side by side, guys. There's literally like a 6-7 inch difference between the rear spring. So the next part is installing the spring. Now you'll see there's a flat side and there's a round side to it. If you look on the stock ones, they don't have that. So it's kind of hard to tell you which way they go. Don't worry. That's what I'm here for. Flat side goes down, the round side goes up. Make sure you reinsert the little rubber bushing that's actually that came off with it, and then we're going to use the perch on top of that, okay?
So
here, so you're going to have a flat top and a round bottom on your spring. The round bottom actually goes down, so sorry if you heard that earlier, that the round bottom goes up, it actually goes down. The flat portion goes up. Here's the perch for that. You're gonna actually not gonna be able to reuse the rubber portion of the perch because they don't fit. So if you heard that earlier, sorry, but now that I actually I'm used to using the other Mark 7s where you can reuse a bunch of other stuff. This one you can't. So this goes here on top. Let's see if you guys can see that. There we go. Yep, you guys can see that now. So, this perch goes here. The flat portion on the spring, that sits there. That's what's going to mate to that. Max is going all the way down on his coils, so we're not using the actual spanner ring. It's actually just going to go to full max low on this right now, immediately. So, one thing you're going to have to pay attention to is when you put this back in, spin it until it kind of makes it very difficult to install. Hold on. Once you have that, put this here, and you're done with that. The next thing is going to be taking out the shock. Once you remove the shock, you're going to reinstall the new one, and we'll show you in just a minute. Alright, so the next portion is removing the shock and the little fuel tank canister, the charcoal canister. You're going to need a 13 millimeter. So make sure you got that first. Right here. I know it's going to be kind of hard to see this, guys, but I'm going to do the best I can because this fender liner is blocking a lot. But it's okay. Pull that out. And then, like I was saying earlier, the little canister just goes down like that. You see that? And a little bit out of the way. You don't want to like drop it because there's actually like plastic lines that go into the fuel tank. And if you break any of those, this is going to be an expensive replacement. So just hang it to the side, okay? So with a couple of extensions and your ratchet and a 16 mil, try to reach that and break loose. Make sure you remember to put these in the same holes that you removed them from because they tend to thread or mate to their hole. So if you mix them up, they're going to be kind of hard to put back in and they can cross thread. Another big thing that you guys are going to realize, these go in at an angle. They do not go straight. So be very careful when removing these and reinstalling them because you can cross thread them really, really easily. So now with the shock removed, you guys are going to see this right here. Take this little cap off, and we need to salvage this and the dust cap right here. So the rest of it is useless to us, so we got to make sure that nut gets removed, because all we need is actually just a strut cap. The new shocks that come with everything new in there, so just giving you guys a heads up. The stock shock uses a 16 mil. Just impact that off since you're not going to reuse the shock anymore. You're going to need what we call like a straight through wrench or socket. Something that holds that so you can use another socket on top of that. As you can see right there, it's kind of a fancy tool. That way you can actually hold this and tighten it down and actually torque it to spec. Without causing any, because you're not supposed to put these on with an impact gun. If you guys want to do that, do it. By all means, it's your choice, your car, your problem. But the way we're supposed to do them, by ratchet, okay? So pretty much just tighten them down. So now that you feel the tension there, just gonna put them on really nice and tight. Don't torque them down too hard, because these actually sit under compression, so it's not a really big deal to have them on really hard. The other thing is that they use a locking nylon nut, so make sure that's there.
So next up in the process is to remount your sway bar. Just put your 13 millimeter bolt back in. This car did not have the light package, so we're not really concerned about the actual leveler that's in the back, so don't worry about that. So the next thing we need to do, unless you guys got the light package with this, then you've got to worry about it. We got to make sure we get the shock for this, the ones that we just took apart earlier. And then so we got that, and remember the 216 bolts are on top. They do go in at an angle, so they don't go straight in, they go kind of sideways like that. So these are easily cross-threaded if you guys don't put them in correctly, so be careful.
So what you're gonna need
need to do is kind of pay attention up here.
Where's the long bolt?
It's gonna be kind of weird. So, but you have to put these in by hand, because if not, they're not gonna go in correctly. You gotta feel for them to go in, because you don't want to strip these. So once you do that side, make sure the other side lines up.
Grab your bolt.
And start the next thread.
As long as they're going nicely by hand, you'll be able to tighten them down afterwards. So there's that. Now, put them on nice and snug.
Hey, Matt.
Just so you guys know that the shock itself only goes in one way, so if it's hard to put back together, then you probably put it in incorrectly.
Could you come here? Is this the sway bar bolt?
Yes.
Because I'll take this apart.
Yes.
It's a really long one. So once you're done with that.
All right, Kelly. See you in the morning. Hey, the meeting's at 6?
All right, so
I'm used to coming in now. I'm used to sleeping.
I'm usually 6:15, 6:30.
So you'll be able to push this back up with your jack, and then line it back up, and then put the bolt through. A little bit of advice for you guys, just a heads up. Get your jack, once you get the bolt on this side in, get your jack towards the edge of it so it can tilt the control arm a little over to the right. That'll allow the shock to line up properly, and then you'll be able to push the bolt through and get it started and tightened down. The next last thing is the last 13 millimeter bolt that's over here with that charcoal canister. I'll show you guys that. Here's this. And that's that notorious one that we kept on talking about earlier. Thing's annoying. It's all hell. But once it's in, put the bolt in. And that's it. Tighten everything down and you're good to go for this side. Repeat the process on the driver's side. Just don't worry about the fender liner as much with the canister. You are going to need to actually unbolt one of the fender liner fittings on one side just to give you access to the two bolts on top. But other than that, that's pretty much it. So now we're going to show you the front of the car, okay? Tried not to. No audio. Okay, so the next thing you're gonna need to do really quick to start on the front, you actually have these little clips right here. You have one. Is there another one? No, there's only one. Yeah, that holds the cowl.
Fit it into that front.
And then
there's a slot.
These little things pop out.
Fit it towards the front.
There you go. And then there's three 13 millimeter bolts right here. Right there. Break those loose. Don't take them off. Just break them loose. Do the same thing on the other side. No big deal. And then we're going to work on the bottom now. Medium max right here is actually working on the bottom right now. So the technique is pretty straightforward.
Let me see. Hold on.
There you go. So max. So put the screwdriver in first. And this is how you remove the axle bolts, because you need to remove them so you can swing the arm out away from the car.
And then,
and then just get your M10 triple square bit and then your ratchet and just break them loose. There's six in total.
So get that going. Once you have all six removed, the next thing is the sway bar end link that he already took off, but we'll tell you how to do that really quick. So that end link right there, you see how he's bending it down. Or try to. Okay.
You get the point.
What size bolt is it?
18.
That's an 18 millimeter nut. Right here. You can do that, remove that one next, and get that one out of the way. After that, you're going to have to remove the ball joint down on the bottom, and that's a 16, right?
Yeah, 16.
Yeah, there's a ball joint right down there. There you go. There's three of them. You got to remove those. With a flathead screwdriver while you're down there, pry on it, and it'll pop out the ball joint out of the spindle. Once you do that, you're going to need the 18 right here for the...
That's a triple square.
The strut nut. And then there's a triple square bolt that goes right here as well. Socket that you're going to need to hold that to break loose the bolt. What size is that triple square?
Whatever the biggest one is.
It's the big one right there.
14.
So that's a 14 triple square, or M14 is the other name for it. Get those going. Once you break all those loose, we'll show you what to do next.
Don't you have to pry the...
Alright, yeah, you gotta take the ball joint off. So, next step on... Right there next to you.
Yeah, I need the jack, please.
Is to remove the ball joint down below. I'll show you guys in just a second. I'm trying to adjust my camera here.
Hang on, Al's gotta be ready.
There you go. So, if you see down below here, there's a ball joint. Max is gonna try to pry it off. Go for it.
Keep going. Keep going. Stop.
So what we're doing is putting a little pressure onto it to pull it up. And use the flathead to pry in between the ball joint. And...
You want me to go down?
It's easier if you go down.
Yeah, go down.
All the way down, actually, that's easier. There you go. Now,
there you go. Go down, all the way.
You're almost out in the front.
So once you get those out, try to pull the spindle towards you, so that way it doesn't get stuck again and go all the way back in like that.
Like it just did?
Yep. But you guys get the point. Once you guys get that, the next thing you're going to need is a strut spreader, which is somewhere around here. We'll get to it in just a moment. So with the strut spreader tool, you put it in, turn it until it spreads open, get a hammer.
Where's the hammer? Who needs a hammer?
Because I saw a lake, a city.
The little helper.
Alright, so it's going to get loud, so turn your volume down because we're going to smack shit. Okay. Ow. Go lower more. Stuck on something.
It's stuck on the blade.
No, it's stuck on this. It's stuck on the sway bar, on the axle.
Axle's out.
No, it's because of the sway bar. So with the strut spreader, you're going to need to spread it on top, and then once you hit the top of the little blade here, if you guys can see my hand, I don't think so, but I need more light. Can you guys shine some light over here so I can show them? Perfect. So you'll see here, you're going to put the strut spreader tool on top here. Eventually it's going to hit this little blade. Let's see, right there where my finger's at. Once it hits that blade, it's going to stop going down. Then you're going to move it underneath the blade right here, and you're going to move it down here, and then that'll let you proceed on pushing it all the way back down. Once that's done, pretty much you'll see the the strut and pretty much spindle, and it's now separated.
Lift up on.
Remove the last three bolts on the top of the cap where we were showing you earlier.
I need you to push up.
I'm holding it.
There's maximum. There you go. There's three bolts there. So once you do those three,
it'll just drop right out, and then we'll show you what to do next.
Here it comes.
Alright, what size socket is that?
21.
That's a 21 mil socket. Hold on. So put that on there. Have someone step on the strut as hard as possible. And use an impact gun. And it's going to get loud. And literally shoot it out.
Tighten it. Loosen, not tighten.
And that's pretty much it. That's all she wrote.
What's that? Did this break?
What the hell is that? Here's Sarina. She's our new friends of Fast member. Oh.
I'm not new. I don't care what the difference is.
So, hold on. So, on this car, well, how far do we go up? An inch?
1 inch.
1 inch from the threads from the bottom, the last thread, up to the bottom of the actual spanner bolt, I guess you want to call it. Compress the spring a little bit, hand tighten the bolt right there, or the nut, I'm sorry. Once you get it on there, now that's a 22 millimeter nut, so we gotta hold that down, and then we gotta get an Allen bolt so we can crank this down by hand and tighten it down to spec. Because they recommend not to use an impact gun when we showed you the unboxing, so don't do it. Not the best thing to do. So we're using pretty much, I guess, a straight through socket with a wrench, ratchet, and then you're going to put the other ratchet on top. You're going to set the ratchet to loosen on the top, and then the bottom one to tighten. Once you have that, tighten them down until it stops, and then give it a really good crank, and then you're done. That's pretty much it for that. Portion of the DIY. All
right, so
right on. Do we want to put the
pretty much we're gonna reverse the process for the installation. Mount the three bolts on the top first. The ones that you removed to drop it. There you go.
Thanks,
those
man.
Three. And then what you're gonna do is try to.
So is this guy? This way.
Yep.
Go ahead and put it in.
It was this way.
Was it?
So you're gonna put the strut back into the. The coil of the strut into the spindle. One key thing you got to remember is make sure that the sway bar end link is facing the correct position here, because if not, you're going to have a hell of a time trying to rotate that around. Okay?
Yeah.
Go. Keep going. Do what you do. Uh-huh. Do what you do.
Get this out of my way, please.
For these coilovers on the All-Track, this is a 2017 All-Track, so this is a brand spanking new car. The coilovers kind of slip right in, kind of like a banana down a hallway. Don't worry about it. It's not a big concern. We realize it's actually, since it's a new car, it's going to slip in pretty easily. Max is doing a good job with that his sunglass tan.
Thanks.
Jeez, man. That
tan. And it just started to go away, too.
Did it?
Yep.
Oh, yeah, because it's been rainy and cloudy. Yeah.
Then we had that sun the other day, you know?
Oh, my goodness, sunshine. Sorry, people. His glass, his suntan is awesome.
It gives him character.
It does. Just so you guys don't know, Max here actually does roofing. He's an elite roofing supply.
No, that's
a supply company.
That's his supply company.
We're Regan Roofing.
Regan Roofing. This guy right here knows everything about roofing. If you need to roof something, make a roofie colada, he knows how to do it.
Hey, calm yourself.
Light's almost dead. So,
pretty much reversed the entire process.
The axle you put in last because it's going to be the hardest thing to put back together, I guess, out of everything.
Same way that you took off the three bolts, go right back on. Just don't use a screwdriver to put it on. You just push down on the control arm, and the ball joint will fall back into place.
Once you do that, tighten that down to torque spec, which is good and tight. There's the end link back in place. Tighten that down. Your oil line, I mean your brake line, has to be put back. Max is up here finishing up the tightening down the three bolts on top. Make sure everything else is good and tight, and you're done. This is how you install SOLOWORKS coilovers on a Golf AllTrak. Hopefully I'm the first to do this on YouTube, so enjoy. Thanks for watching Pichao's Garage with Serena, with Max, and Max. Have a good one. Thanks, SOLOWORKS, by the way. Matt and Glenn, you guys are awesome. Peace.
Thanks, Glenn.
Thanks.
Thank you.